In this video, I'm going to try to make sense out of all the directory options from Microsoft. Hello everyone, my name is Travis and this is Seraltos. There's a lot of confusion with identity services from Microsoft and Azure. I get it, there are like three identity options all with Active Directory in the name. In this video, I'm going to review the different options and give some examples of how each may be used. Hopefully, I'll be able to help answer the question, do we still need domain controllers? Before I jump into that, please take a second to subscribe. It's painless and it might even bring you good luck. I'm going to just jump into it by outlining the three different directory services that can be somewhat confusing. They are Active Directory Domain Services, Azure Active Directory, and Azure Active Directory Domain Services. First up is Active Directory Domain Services. I've been calling this Active Directory or AD since Server 2000, and I'm not going to stop for this video. Active Directory is an on-premise directory service used by the majority of companies over the past 20-ish years. Here are some characteristics in no particular order. It's a hierarchical directory, it has an extensible schema, it stores objects such as users, computers, group, and security principles. You can use group policies to manage users and devices. It's highly available multi-master, but that does require multiple servers. It supports Kerberos, LDAP, and NTLM for authentication. It's based on standards such as LDAP and DNS, and it requires dedicated domain controllers. Active Directory has been around for a long time and is well documented. It does require dedicated servers, and relatively speaking, it uses a lot of resources, both from compute for things like backup, version updates and patching, network resources for replication, also management of users, groups, sites. From that perspective, I can see why some might be interested in an alternative. Next is Azure Active Directory. If you use an O365 or product or Azure, you have Azure AD. It's very different from Active Directory Domain Service, but the two complement each other. While AD supports network-based authentication like Kerberos and NTLM, Azure AD supports web-based authentication such as OAuth and SAML. Here's a list of characteristics. It's a cloud-based identity solution. It's used for Office 365 and Azure user management. It contains users, groups, applications, and security principles. It leverages web-based OAuth 2, SAML 2, or OpenID for authentication. It can be managed with Graph API. It's multi-tenant and it has a flat architecture. It's not extensible, there's no GPOs. There's four licensing options, free, basic, premium 1, and premium 2, each one with more features and a higher price as you move along. It's tenant-based and tied to an enrollment. Let's pause the overview for a minute and go over how these two directory services complement each other. Remember that Active Directory, the on-premises one, uses network authentication like Kerberos and NTLM, and Azure Active Directory is cloud-based and uses OAuth and SAML for accessing cloud-based services like O365. Now, wouldn't it be great if you could synchronize these two somehow so users and admins didn't have to manage two different identities for services in the cloud and on-premises? Well, let me introduce you to AD Connect. This is a small service that runs on your internal network that replicates IDs and other attributes from Active Directory to Azure Active Directory. It can replicate password hashes and gives users the same username and passwords for on-premises AD and Azure AD services. It's capable of more than that, but that's outside the scope of this video. Let's get back to it with the third Active Directory option, this time Azure Active Directory Domain Services. This is close to the traditional on-premises AD that we all know and love, but hosted in Azure. Here are some characteristics. It's a cloud-based PaaS offering. It supports LDAP, Kerberos, and NTLM. It's compatible with Windows Active Directory Domain Services, and it integrates with Azure AD. There are no domain or enterprise admin accounts. You cannot extend the schema. You cannot trust other forests or domains. And LDAP is read-only. Azure AD Domain Services uses Azure AD as a source for management. So objects added to and managed from Azure AD are replicated to Azure AD DS. Now, what happens if we put all of these three services together? In this configuration, identities are created in AD, synchronized to Azure AD with AD Connect, and then to Azure Active Directory Domain Services. But why would you do this? Let's say you have an IIS application that doesn't support modern authentication and you want to move it quickly to Azure without having to deploy servers as domain controllers. With this model, you can lift and shift the server into Azure without deploying AD servers or relying on a VPN or ExpressRoute connection back to your network. Here's a breakdown of the services and limitations that I went over. This is not all-inclusive by any means, but it should give you an idea of how these services compare to each other. So, are domain controllers still needed? I've been in this business for 20 years, and I'll give you the qualified answer of it depends. If you're cloud native, no servers on premises, and using Azure AD Join along with mobile device management solutions like Intune, you may be able to leverage just Azure AD. If you're cloud native but have third-party applications that require Active Directory, you may be able to get away with Azure AD and Azure AD domain services. The sticking point will be no domain or enterprise admin. That may become hard to work around, especially with third-party applications. For the rest, companies that rely on traditional Active Directory for user and group management, need to extend schemas and rely on trust relationship, you will be stuck with domain controllers for some time. Azure AD directory services can still be leveraged, but it will complement traditional Active Directory, not replace it. Hopefully this information will help you understand the different directory services offered by Microsoft and how they may be applied to your organization. I hope you found this helpful. Please don't forget to subscribe, and thanks for watching.